but still the cholesterol is there, the calories are still there. No, sir. Cholesterol is inside every cell of human, of every animal. So by taking out the fat, you cannot get rid of the cholesterol. Again, it's a topic which, if you are interested, I would welcome you to attend our full-day seminar where we can go into the depths of that. So from a weight loss point of view, what I'm trying to say is, this is the food which is high fat, high protein and low fiber. And this is what enables a baby calf to double its weight in 8 weeks. So if you want to put that kind of food into your body, it's going to have weight loss. But it's not just, you know, me. So this is a doctor called Dr. Spock. I don't know if you've heard about this gentleman. He is the world's leading, America's leading pediatric doctor. I mean, you know, what happens is that in our country, you know, we have joint family. We have a mother, mother-in-law, grandfather, grandmother, uncle, aunt. So whenever you bring up a child, you know, we have all the people to ask for advice. In America, the single families are there, nuclear families, husband and wife and the kid. So they don't know what to do when the child is falling sick, what, how to bring up the child. This is a book, therefore, it's a Bible. It's been 15, 20, 30 years of print, or maybe more possibly. The gentleman is 77 years now, 77 years old. Huh? He's no more. Oh, I didn't know that. So whatever. But so let's listen to what he says. So he himself has water and milk. So in his latest edition, 7th edition, he says, you know, it's not good. In fact, if you read the book, he says he had certain allergies, he had some coughs, cold himself, which for 77 years, you know, he lived with that. And he gave up all these milk products and within few months, everything vanished. So, you know, it's not even here. So, milk is related to all health problems. Again, I won't have time to go into this here, but just to give you an idea of the kind of health problems associated with milk, all these things are a direct result of consumption of milk, dahi, curd, lassi, chhas, buttermilk, ghee, all these things. And again, this is a website. You can visit there. It gives all the information. And if you want more information, again, you can come to one of our seminars. You can attend a full-day seminar and you can get a lot more information about all these things. So, but this is not a seminar about health. It's about weight loss. And as far as I'm concerned, if you want to lose weight, you know, dairy products are high calorie, high fat, high cholesterol, zero fiber, and not recommended. And this is actually Times of India 3-4 days ago. So this, like, this stuff keeps coming. I don't want to go into the details. Okay, so point number 4. Lots of fruits, lots of vegetables, no animal products, no dairy products. Point number 5 is no deep fried food. So unfortunately in India, snacks are deep fried. You have samosas, you have vada, you have jalebi, you have fafada, you have God knows what all. Except there are a few. Okay, so unfortunately we have a problem. McDonald's stuff, of course, is almost 100% deep fried. Almost. You know, KFC, everything. But why? Again, high fat, high calorie. You know, a baked potato has got 0.4 grams of fat, but you know, you make it into a French fry and see what happens to it. So it's the oil that causes the problem. And besides this, it's extremely high calorie. But besides all this, there are even risks of cancer. So the National Cancer Institute talks about, you know, fried food, you know, especially French fry stuff like that. When you deep fry this stuff at a very high temperature, this compound called acrylamide is formed, and it's actually a cancer risk. That's a side thing. From a weight loss perspective, the important thing is, like I said, extremely high fat, high calorie, and usually high cholesterol if it's made out of non-veg stuff, made out of chicken or meat or fish or whatever. Point number 6. Okay, we suggest avoiding processed food. What is processed food? Anything that comes in a can, jar, packet, bottle, you know, it's not come out of factory. It's not raw, made by a plant. It's not cooked in a home or cooked in a restaurant. It's gone to a factory and something happened to it there. Then it's put into a packet, some label is put on it, you know. So this food, I would recommend you avoid. It's not possible 100% to avoid. Okay, sometimes you go and you have a little bit, is okay. You know, I'm not talking about a military rule system that, you know, 100%, this is it. And you have one French fry or one piece of potato chip and you're doomed for life.
What about the pickle and
chips? Yeah. Yeah, again, not recommended, you know. Again, pickle, you have a little bit of pickle to make it okay. Or jam, again, maybe a little bit you have, okay, but the problem is a little bit of pickle, a little bit of jam, a little bit of chas, a little bit of ghee, a little bit of butter, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, and finally you are, you know, you are nowhere, you know. So that's the problem.
If you buy organic jam from a farmer's market, it's fine, right?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't recommend if you're trying to lose weight that you have pots and pots of it, but you have a little bit on the side and you have it in the bread, it's okay, you know. So I would rather say you have the fruit, you know. Oh, you know, not even the juice. Coming back to the processed food, you know, you have all this stuff, you know, go to a supermarket, it's full of this processed food here. And, you know, why we say no, you know, it's got all the, if you look at the label, it's got all these ingredients, we don't even know what. Typically, they have got lots of sugar, lots of salt. That's what, you know, makes you eat more. You know. Very often, they've got milk and milk products in it. You know, biscuits, cakes, pretty surprised, you know, sometimes even bread has got milk in it. And then all of them use, most of them use refined flour. I mean, nowadays a few are there which use whole wheat, but most of them, like normal white bread you get, Britannia white bread or whatever, or the, all the biscuits, Mari biscuits and all, the normal one, now the new healthy ones are different. But use, all of them use refined flour, which is maida. So loss of fiber. Again, too much of calorie because you remove the fiber, you start eating more. Chemicals, preserve, God knows what's in that. You know. So they're engineered to cause you to over. You know, there's a famous ad of Safe, you know, challenge you to eat just one chip. You can't eat one, you know, eat one and you want to eat more and more. So, you know, processed food is again, no. Point number 7 is we prefer whole foods over refined foods. So, I would not suggest you have white bread. I would suggest you have whole wheat bread. I wouldn't suggest you have white rice. I suggest you have brown rice. I wouldn't suggest you have white sugar. You know, you either have a fruit, you have a dried fruit like a date, or you have at the jaggery, good, you know. But white sugar, if you want to have, you know, oil, you have peanuts or nuts, almonds or seeds instead of having the oil. Again, why? The primary reason is loss of nutrients and loss of fiber. So if you look at a whole grain, a typical grain, wheat or anything, you know, so there is an outer layer called the bran. And there is the germ, which is the nutrient-rich part, and is the endosperm, the middle part. So you, when you are doing the milling, you know, all this fiber, everything goes away. You're left with the middle part. You know. So a lot of nutrients. In fact, John Robbins, who's written a very famous book called Diet for a New America, he has given the percentage of loss of nutrients when the whole wheat flour is made into white flour. So a tandoori roti versus a naan or a rumali roti, you know, there's a whole loss of nutrient loss. So, the nutrient is lost and the fiber is lost. The fiber is lost, you tend to overeat. You know, you can't eat, you know, if I gave you apples to eat, you know, how many apples? 1, 2, 3. But if I give you apple juice to drink, you can drink, you know, half a liter. Yeah. And to make half a liter of juice, you would have like 20 apples or something like that. Yeah. You know, so it's very, very easy to overeat on this stuff. So, and you lose your fiber, you lose your vitamins, lose your minerals, and you tend to overeat. All these reasons we say, go for whole foods. This is a difficult part because you go to the market, you get rice, typical rice you get is white rice. You have to make an effort to get whole brown rice. It's costly also. Okay? But if you want to go bread, nowadays people have become more health conscious of brown bread. Earlier you used to go to a health food shop to get it. Now every corner, everywhere, they have brown bread. So people are whole wheat bread. So people are
multi-grain,
seven grain. See, finally, why do you think people like me are doing talks? We want to spread the word. If all of you go back and start asking your grocery fellow, give me brown bread, and you don't have, the fellow says, oh, I'm losing business. Yeah, he tells a company, and finally that goes back somewhere, and somewhere they say, okay, yeah, we have to make this thing. There's a market demand for it. So similarly, if you do rice, you know, it'll happen. You know, so nowadays you see all the advertising the drinks, no preservatives, no chemicals, no additives, no colors, no flavor. Why? The market demand.
But is that true? No preservatives?
If they say, I mean, I suppose it's true, but you'd be very careful. If they say no colors, that means there are flavors, there are preservatives, there are additives. So you have to read, not only read what is there, you have to read what is not there.
But by common rule of thumb, if it is 100% natural, and they put it in the bottle and they seal it,
yeah, so basically what they do is all these are pasteurized. So they're heated very high temperature, kill everything, and then vacuum dried, put into so that heating process destroys even more of the nutrients. So, you know, I would say have a fruit, you know, or if you must make a juice, make it in your house, you know, with a juicer, whatever, and have it. You know. But preferably, again, when you're making the juice, you're throwing away all the fiber. So you're losing a hell of a lot. You know, why are you losing it out here? So another issue with refined food, the first issue is of course the fact that, you know, it's no fiber And second thing is, you know, actually, you know, if you read this, it says you have refined grains, refined sugar. You know, it puts the insulin, it drives the insulin drives the sugar into your blood cells. The blood sugar goes down, your appetite increases, and you start eating more. So this is a direct consequence.
What about the refined food, sorry, salt?
Okay, salt is a topic for another session. I would say is, you know, I wouldn't, like, as you are going to see, I'm going to remove a lot of things from your diet. If I remove salt as well, then you're going to probably run away from here. Yeah, definitely I would say, the iodized salt you get, sea salt, rock salt, definitely, sanda namak they call it, is definitely better, you know, less sodium. Okay, even sugar, for example, there's a gentleman, you can go look at this video, is a Robert Lustig, he gave a lecture called Sugar, the Bitter Truth. 800,000 times that people have viewed it. This guy actually goes on to say it is a poison, you know. I mean, I don't know, maybe it is, maybe it's not, but I know for sure it's not good for health. I don't know if it's a poison or not, but, you know, is it toxic or not, I don't know. But surely, you know, you're trying to lose weight, sugar is like a no-no. The link. You can take a copy of the presentation later from the health library or from me later. You know, I can give you the whole presentation, not a problem. It'll be probably put up on the website also. It'll be put up on my website also. You can download it. It's share it with others, no problem. My website is called Prana, PRANA. PRANA. PR, Prana, Prana. PRANA. So it'll be there, and probably it'll be in the, I don't know, do you put up presentation also, or you only put up the video? Yeah, so you can even take from health library also, not a problem. Okay. Point number 8 is to go oil free, at least at home. Oil is, you know, at 9 calories per gram, and you tend to deep fry things in it, and, you know, they contribute to cholesterol, triglycerides, all kinds of fat, polyunsaturated fat, monounsaturated fat. I don't want to get into all the details, but, you know, all oils are bad for health, and if they heated oils, refined oils, even worse. Well, what I'm saying is, any plant product is free of cholesterol. So if you take a peanut oil, a sunflower oil, yes, almond oil, yes, they are cholesterol free. But like you said, they encourage the body to produce more cholesterol. So coming back, the composition of the American diet, you see, 51% is refined and processed foods, 42% is animal products and dairy, and only 7% fruits and vegetables. I don't know about the Indian system, Indian percent, but it would be somewhat similar, you know. You know, you go to a typical hotel, you know, a typical meal, you have, how much is, you know, whole foods? How much of that is fruits and vegetables? Maybe 10%, 15%, 85% is all this stuff. So this is what is causing the obesity epidemic. Now we're coming to the end of it. Point number 9 is, you know, no overeating, you know, slowly, and, you know, when you're like, when you burp, or when you feel full, like, stop, you know, don't have it more. It's going to, if you, you can, you can